Hi, my name is Alan from Hawkdive and welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you once again how I will use ChatGPT to create another Python game. This time I would like to recreate PingPong from scratch, and this time I want it to be faster. I want to make it faster. I want to run a game from an executable or at least a single file, and those are my goals. And I'm going to head over to my desktop. And I'm going to show you the whole experience or the whole process of me creating the ping pong game from scratch without knowing still how to code with Python. And literally just prompting ChatGPT to do things that I need and want. So yeah, let's start. I'm going to go to my computer. Okay, so let's start. So I'm currently on my browser. I open chat.openai.com, which is ChatGPT, and I'm going to prompt it that I want to build a Python game. The idea is to, of course, recreate the famous ping pong games, and I would like it to be only on Python, which is the language that I want to write on. And the thing is, I do not know how to code it and what things I should use. So I'm going to prompt it using Python. And what program can you tell me, the things that I would need? So it's going to, prompt me the stuff that it is going to prompt me. Of course, it says here, the first one that I should do is download Python because that's the language that I want to code in. So it provided me a link with that. So that's cool. I choose a game development framework. It suggested Pygame because I think that's the easiest one. So it provided me a link to that too for the code command or for the download basically. And then it suggested me to learn Python, learn Pygame, start the coding, and then test it. I can refine. But the first choice that I've, worked with here is, of course, to download the Python software. So basically, I went to the python.org/download, which is a provided link. I am on a Windows machine, so I just went and clicked download Python. And of course, I'm just going to download it, save it. And once it is saved, I'm going to run it. So right here, it popped up with modify, repair, and whatsoever. I did not have to reinstall it, or basically I just modified, repair it, and added the precompile standard library because that makes things faster. And I did not have to install from scratch because it was already installed in my system if you did watch my last ChatGPT video. There you go. It's going to install. It's going to do its own thing. And so now that we're back on the website, or ChatGPT says choose and develop the framework. And then as you can see, I'm now on the pygame.org, which is, the pygame, the framework that we're going to be using to provide the game. And it shows you a lot of different things that you can build with Python here on the right side. There are also news. And of course, the top part right here, which is the command line, is what you used to install. So I forgot, I'm trying to act as if I do not know anything about this, right? But I forgot to ask ChatGPT, how do I use that code? But for you guys, luckily you're in this video, you just have to open Windows PowerShell, paste the command in there, and good. But as you saw, it was already installed in my system as well, so it did not have to install it. But basically, you just paste it in the PowerShell, and then you're good. But now I'm gonna act again. What programming language, actual programming tool or program should I use? Is what I meant in this one. Like, what IDE? So IDE, in simplest term, is basically the program that you're going to use to code whatever you're trying to code. So as you can see, it suggested me a lot of things here, such as PyCharm, Visual Studio Code, which is very famous, especially for every Windows user. And then an IDLE, which is the official Python. It comes with the Python actually, and Spider, but I was like, I already have one. So I'm going to be telling ChatGPT now that is Sublime Text fine. And there you go. It says here that Sublime Text is a great text editor, but it doesn't have such features, especially for the actual Python language that we have, or Python programming IDEs that we have, some features. But it was great. And I think it was going to work because this video would pop up on your feed and it is going to work fine for me. So I'm prompting ChatGPT now. Okay, guide me from scratch on the coding game. Like, tell me what to do on Sublime Text. As you can see, ChatGPT jumped in straight up with the code. Pip install Pygame, import Pygame, And I stopped it because I was like, please start from the start. After, or like as soon as I open Sublime Text, which is the IDE or the programming application that we're going to use. So there you go. It says step-by-step guide, install Sublime Text, which, you know, I already have installed package control, which we are going to be installing Pygame from, but we already did have Pygame earlier, so we don't have to reinstall it now. That's good. Step 4, create a new Python file. This is Control N or Command N on Mac. Oh, we're good with that. And then now add import statements. Show codes again. Codes that I can copy paste, and also explains the code that I'm pasting, that I'm about to paste. But I'm a lazy guy. I just want ChatGPT to do everything for me. So basically, I did not really check the code much. I literally just copy pasted it like a blind date, if that makes sense. But there you go. We got all the steps. I'm going to open Sublime Text as if I'm going to be downloading it again, just to show you guys. Download for Windows. That's where you get it from. Now going back to the tab of ChatGPT. And then minimizing, just to show you guys that I already have a Sublime Text. I'm just going to cancel this one. I'm going to go back. It says install Pygame. I was going to show you, but I realized that I already have Pygame. I already showed you how to install it, so we didn't have to, but I accidentally pressed enter, so those things popped up. So I created a side-by-side view right here so that we can see the code and ChatGPT and our programming application, which is Sublime Text, on the right. So as you can see, I'm starting to copy things now from the ChatGPT prompt. So I'm just pressing copy code, control V-ing, which is basically pasting it on the Sublime Text. And then there you go. I just copied everything. Copy, and then boom, we got a game. Actually, that is not the finished game. You're going to be seeing here in a moment, but you know, of course, we have to save it first. I created a PingPong folder over at my desktop so that I can easily save the file that we have, of course. But as you can see, blank game window, whatever, blah, blah, blah. We're going to file, save it first. Going to head over to the language or the folder that we created, which is PingPong. We're going to go and head over to Python as the file type, and I'm going to name it PingPong. Okay, cool. Now, after saving that, as you can see, there are now colors on our Sublime Text because it has now realized that, yeah, we are programming in Python and it should work as a Python file. Now, I'm going to ask ChatGPT, is that code fully functional? Like, can I just copy paste that? And it's going to tell me the code it provided was just a basic skeleton of the Pygame window with a game loop. And it doesn't have the actual balls and the paddles that, you know, the ping pong game needs to have. So what should I do now? Because I'm so lazy, I was just like, can you just code me a full game of ping pong instead? A full one that I can just copy and paste, but ChatGPT will be, hey, I'm sorry, but I, as an AI language, I am unable to provide you one thing that you're asking. So it's gonna show me again several steps, but I'm just gonna disregard that. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to open up another window in ChatGPT. There you go, new chat. And I'll be like, hey, can you show me a full ping pong code that was written with Python or in Python? So it's going to provide me a full simple Python code. Right now it says Java, Arduino, Makefile. It says Turtle Module. I don't know what that is. I have no idea. We're using Pygame. We're not using Turtle. So now I tried regenerating, and surely enough, it gave me the one with Pygame, because that's, I think, the second best thing that it can provide me. So right there, it is now providing me a full code. It's just going to write it. There you go. It finished writing, but I did copy that one and pasted it over to the Sublime Text. Control A, Control V. And then Control A, Control C, Control V. And then I saw the code was not looking too finished for my eyes at least. So I was like, continue. And then it explained me. The Pygame library, create a simple ping pong game. The game involves two player controlling paddles to hit. And yeah, it's a two player game. It wasn't the random one. But there, to run the game, simply save the code in a file with a .py extension. But what if I don't know how to run it? Let's say I don't know. So I ask ChatGPT. It says install pygame, blah, blah, blah. And then, you know, save the code with the extension of .py, run the code, open a command. Let's say if I open cmd, I can just type in Python and then pingpong.py. And it's going to launch the ping pong game. But actually, this one is as it is. It can actually just run the game. I tried it here, so I went to command prompt. And as soon as I dragged the game and pressed enter without running anything, it just worked. So I was like, okay, that is cool. So I had a realization that this game can be run with just you opening the game. So as you can see, I suck. I was trying to play it as a solo player, but you know, I suck. And as you can see, the scores were happening on the left. And also, that was basically it. I didn't have to do anything. And yeah. And that's about it. That was so quick. It took me less than an hour, and I was able to do a two-player ping pong game. It is not a single-player ping pong game. It's a two-player ping pong game that allows me to use W and S on my keyboard for the left player, and for the right player, I just use the up and down arrow key on my keyboard. So here we go. I do actually have the file right here, but first let me open it on Sublime Text. So Sublime Text is the same thing that we did use last time. So I decided to just use Sublime Text again because it looks very nice in the eye. So this is the whole code. I coded nothing. And if, let me see if I still have it here. Yeah. If I go back up here on ChatGPT, provided me the whole code. Literally the whole code. A simple ping pong game. So it gave me, you know, it defined the colors for me. It set the screen dimensions that, the playing field is. And it imported the pygame, which we did install. Given by ChatGPT, of course. And then it created the screen. It even shows you, like, there's comments for codes just in case you want to change them. So, you know, made a clock, the left paddle, which is the left player, the right paddle, which is the right player, and then gave an initial ball speed, which I could have lowered down because it was too fast at the start. You know what? I'm going to do 3 and 3 because why not? Right, so we got the ball paddle right here. It has its own gravity, it has its own thing, the speed with the game loop that, you know, it just goes on and on and on and on and gives the score on the command prompt. And then of course the game is running on 60 hertz. So what if I do 144, because that's my monitor. So that's cool. Those are the only changes that I did, which is, you know, I literally just did it right now. And what if I want the screen dimension to be 1280 by now? I think it's not gonna size up, so I'm not going to change that, but I'm just going to do Control S. I'm going to exit out of Sublime Text, and I can just double click the ping pong file that we have right here, and it's going to run the game. Python, boom, running the game. The ball is still so fast, and I cannot play it with just my hand, but look, it is now running way better. But I suck at the game. It's so hard to control two paddles at the same time, but you get the idea of the game. It is actually fun, I'm not gonna lie. And I coded nothing of it. Literally, just... Oh, where's my thing? I think I pulled it too down, yep. There are no boundaries, so... Actually, can I... I want to do an experiment. I want to edit this one more time on Sublime Text. I'm gonna drag the file. Yo, what if I do 1280 by 720, which is the usual window size for games nowadays. Scroll that, open this, running on, it's not gonna, it's literally endless, it's not gonna properly bound, so we can skip that part. But you see, the game is working full without me literally knowing anything about coding a game in Python language, and I think that is just an amazing thing. I'm probably gonna do more in the future, more advanced one or a different language one. But yeah, that is it for me. Again, my name is Alan. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you did like this type of content, make sure to like and subscribe on the Hawkdive YouTube channel. Check out our articles. We create them There's a lot of them daily articles are pumping out in the Hawkdive.com, you know, blog space, article space, about tech content, such as the latest tech news, and of course, those tips and tricks that you probably would want to know because it's going to help your life a lot more. So, yeah. Again, my name is Alan, and I'll see you guys in my next video in the Hawkdive YouTube channel. I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.